Welcome to Digits. I'm Steve Russolillo. The Obama administration has suffered enough criticism associated with healthcare.gov, so now they're calling in the big guns. President Obama has called on Microsoft executive Kurt DelBene to lead the initiative. WSJ White House correspondent Colleen McCain-Nelson joins us from Washington. Colleen, thanks so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So Colleen, tell us, who exactly is Kurt DelBene?
Well, he was a senior executive at Microsoft for a number of years. He officially retired in July, and now the Obama administration has tapped him to succeed Jeffrey Zients in leading the overhaul of healthcare.gov, the very troubled website. And so DelBene starts Wednesday, no time like the present. He's going to start the job right away, work with Zients in the transition, and help make sure that healthcare.gov is fixed and that the rest of the enrollment period goes off better than the beginning of the enrollment period went.
Is it surprising that they tapped a former Microsoft executive here, or I guess, you know, what sort of went behind the decision-making process to actually get to Kurt?
Well, the White House certainly recognized that they needed some technical expertise. They needed someone with management expertise, but also someone with some familiarity in this realm. And so they made the decision to kind of create this job and to tap Jeff Zients to first take the job kind of on the fly as the website was melting down, as so many problems were happening. So that was a very quick decision they made. By all accounts, Zients made a lot of progress, but he was always to be a short-term appointment. He already is tapped to take on the job heading up the president's National Economic Council in a couple months. And so Zients was always supposed to be there for a few months and then leave. And so the White House has since said that they recognize that they need some private sector expertise, some technical expertise, as well as management experience. And so it's not surprising that they look to the private sector and to a company like Microsoft for that.
Right, obviously a well-established name. So who is he going to now be working with? What is the structure going to look like?
Well, that's a really good question. The White House has not ever been entirely clear on kind of the hierarchy that Zients fit into. What they're saying today is that DelBene will be a senior advisor to Kathleen Sebelius, who is the Health and Human Services Secretary. So ostensibly, he'll be reporting to her, but he also will be working in consultation with the head of CMS, the Medicare and Medicaid Services Division. And he also will be working closely with QSSI, the company that has taken over as kind of the general contractor on this project. So he'll work closely with Marilyn Tavner and QSSI, but ostensibly he's a senior advisor to Ms. Sebelius.
So you're covering the White House every single day. Obviously, healthcare.gov has been in the news, been front page news for weeks now. How urgent was this for them to make a move now? And just sort of big picture here, what can we expect next for this site heading into the end of the year and into 2014?
Right. Well, this was definitely an important decision that the White House took very seriously. Once Zients came on board and progress started to become evident, the White House faced some pressure to make this a more permanent position, to not just bring Zients in for a couple months and then go back to kind of a free-for-all. And so some senators even wrote a letter to the White House and said, we really think this needs to be a permanent position. And so DelBene comes in now at an important moment, because even though the site is working better on the front end for consumers, they're still working on the build out of the back end of the site. They still need to make sure that people who think they're enrolled actually are enrolled, that insurers get correct information. And so December 23rd is the deadline for people to enroll to have coverage January 1st. And so the period of the next few weeks is a very crucial period to make sure that the first wave of people enrolling actually get coverage, get payments, that insurers get the information they need. And so there's still some key moments coming up and some important tests for the website.
All right, we will all be watching this very closely. Colleen McCain-Nelson from Washington, D.C., thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
And I'm Steve Russolillo. Thanks for watching Digits.